Over the last year or so, we've seen a fundamental shift in the private equity market that is really looking for impact investment and looking for outcomes. And we certainly think that being a B Corporation is going to lead to a whole new direction and chapter in terms of the underlying investment structure that we have.
You know, you talk a lot about, you know, not profits and shareholder value, but these are fairly hard concepts to swallow when you are like sort of struggling to survive as a business or sort of fighting for your square of land. Like, what has been the benefits to IQ for stepping up and being measured by B Corp?
One of the most important intangible benefits of becoming a B Corporation occurred at the end of 2018 when we were recognized as the winners of the Conscious Companies Awards in South Africa. And that really accelerated and emphasized the direction that we were taking and our philosophy and approach that had been certified by B Corporation. And really all of these steps were preparatory steps in forming and articulating our purpose to grow people, grow business, and grow Africa.
I think the ultimate knock-on of this is obviously you're doing good with the Cobra Initiative, but I think there's, in terms of the profile of IQ Business and the perception in the market and how people perceive you, would be fundamentally altered at the end of this because of how you've behaved now. And I'm not sure if those dividends are going to repay, you know, in February, March this year, but I think long term, it's better than any ad campaign you could ever run or any sort of marketing initiative you could ever do. I think it'll stand out way more and sit with people for much, much longer.
I was reading an article at the weekend, Ross, that was asking the question that is probably going to be asked in retrospect in years to come by our children and grandchildren. Your two-year-old might ask you the question, Daddy, what did you do during the pandemic crisis? Being able to respond and say, well, this is what we did. This is how I participated, supported, responded to the situation. And certainly, I think sitting on one's hands is not an answer. We've been in operation of our COBRA initiative, the COVID Business Rescue Assistance Initiative, and we've launched several other initiatives. So each of these initiatives have really been, if I can say so, a no-brainer. It hasn't taken us through a deep thought process to decide how we should engage. And indeed, we talk about running towards the problem. And if I can give a very brief metaphor, it almost feels like, you know, one has arrived at a major road accident. And there are three choices that one can make as you're sitting behind the steering wheel. The first choice is that you can put your car into reverse and get the hell out of there and run away from the problem to safeguard yourself. The second response is to sit in your car and just freeze and just look and see what's happening, but feel helpless, perhaps unqualified to go and deal with the situation that has been there, to wait for the emergency services to arrive to deal with it. Or the third response is simply to fling your door open and run out of your vehicle to go and help, to go and be part of the situation. That very much is what occurred to us last year. And it was that third case that we really didn't have to think about what our response should be. We need to be part of engaging with the problem, providing solutions, and using our business as a force for good in the current crisis. The impact that we've seen so far, which is one of those intangibles, because it's always very difficult to measure. But even if I were to say, I mean, the people that I met over the festive season that were distant friends or individuals that I didn't know very well, and I didn't meet very many people because of lockdown, but so many times they were asking the questions about COBRA and about what had occurred and how we had developed it. And it's clearly had an impact, I think, in terms of elevating conversations in the country. We're approaching the first anniversary of lockdown. And indeed, at this point, there is no end in sight for that. But what it meant was, as the crisis was building, we were crystal clear about the role that we needed to play. There really was very little need to spend time strategizing or thinking through how we could play our part as a B Corporation and use our business as a force for good in the climate or the economic crisis that we see at this stage.